Hi guys, we have Nick Perrins on the line here from the Mersey Gig Guard. Nick, how are you tonight?
Hi Doug, I'm very well, thanks. How are you?
I'm marvellous, thank you very much. Just wanted to get you on tonight to have a little chat with me about the Mersey Gig Guard. To all our listeners, I'm sure a lot of them are aware, a lot of them are already on your rota. But what is the service? What is the service you're offering exactly?
Okay, well, the Mersey Gig Guard is basically a gig listings website. And it's available for bands and venues across Merseyside to go on there and basically just publicise their gigs. It's all free. There's nothing on there for the bands and venues that I will ask for payment for when it comes to gig promotion. And there's a submit your gig button on the homepage, and if they click that, they can just go on there and put all their gig details in. So it's something that it's been going since January 2014, and all the gigs that get put on there basically get a load of promotion on my social media sites. I've got just over 11,000 people following me on my various social media sites. And also The Link, which is a local newspaper. I do a monthly listing for them as well. So any band or venue that put their gigs on the gig guide stand a chance of me picking that gig out and putting it in The Link, which gets 40,000 readers every month. And then also I do a radio show every Sunday night on Wirral Radio, and a lot of the gigs get mentioned on there as well. So it's basically just a free gig listings website, and it's a bit of a boost for bands and venues around Merseyside to help them with some free promo for all the events and gigs they've got going on as well.
Yeah, it's a brilliant service, isn't it? Obviously, we've teamed up a little bit, and I've got you on our website now for bands to go
yeah.
through. Because I found a lot of bands were asking me, but I focus more on the radio side of it and sort of going out there and getting some footage when they play live. So, but lots of bands were asking me, you know, can you list more of our gigs? And I thought to myself, well, I can only do so much. So that's why I asked you, and you kindly accepted to let me advertise on my website your service.
Yeah, well, to be honest, Doug, it was really nice getting the call from you, because when I started the gig guide, that was kind of the vision that I had for it, you know, that maybe I could team up with other people like you who are doing things for the local music industry. And, you know, if people want their gigs listing on your website and I'm already doing that, then it just, you know, it seems like a natural fit that instead of you doing the same job that I'm doing, that we should get together and help everybody out together. So,
well, it makes total sense, so, yeah. doesn't it? It makes total sense. I mean, that's what I'm after myself. I'm sort of after the similar things as you, more of a network of people all working for the same cause, you know what I mean?
Exactly, and it just seems crazy that there are so many people, you know, doing great things out there for the Liverpool music industry, because we all want it to succeed, don't we? You know, I mean, it's gone through a really tough time. There isn't a lot of money out there, and there are a lot of people like yourself and like me that just want to do whatever we can to help out. And so, you know, strength in numbers. And if we can all come together and do it together, then that's even better, isn't it?
All the better, exactly. I mean, that's I do this radio show, you know, me like yourself, we both work, don't we, for a living? So we have limited time, don't we? So I just think the more we can have people together, the more resources
exactly.
we can have, you know what I mean? I mean, I would love to have all kinds on Round Sound Radio, but it's finding the time, to be honest with you, I won't lie.
Yeah. No, well, that's the thing. And I think most of the bands and venues out there really appreciate, you know, what we're doing for them. And basically, every little bit helps, doesn't it? You know, whatever we're doing to promote the gigs, it's got to be better than not doing anything. So I think it's just really a case of making sure that all the bands and venue owners and anybody really that organises gigs, so all the promoters out there as well, that they're aware that the service is there. So the fact that it's on your website now as well is brilliant. And, you know, like you said, you know, there's nothing in it for us, is there? There's nothing in it for me.
Nope.
It's just there, and I want bands to get the very best out of it. One thing I would say, though, as well, is that people need to be a little bit more open, I think, to doing things that aren't on Facebook.
Yes.
And it's great for bands to publicise their gigs on their own Facebook pages, but they're only promoting those gigs then to the fans that they've already got, you know, the people
the
that already follow them on Facebook
yeah.
and Twitter. Whereas if they use the gig guide, they're then promoting that gig to, you know, 11,000 other people, plus all the people that read the papers that I do the listings for and everything as well. So
well,
it just makes sense for them to use it, really.
Well, Liverpool is a tourist destination as well, isn't it?
Exactly, absolutely. And, you know, I I actually do quite a lot of marketing for the Gig Guide, so the tourist board know about it and loads of other people know about it. So when people come to Liverpool for a weekend or a hen night or a shopping trip or whatever, if they want to sit in a pub and listen to a live band, they'll go on the Mersey Gig Guide and find out what gigs are on that day, you know. So it's really important that the bands make sure their gigs are on that gig guide, otherwise the punters will just go somewhere else.
I mean, getting you guys involved with the show was an easy decision, really, because I'm attracting lots of bands to my website, obviously, through their music and playing their music and promoting their music. But I, as I say, I wasn't listing any of them, so it was common sense, wasn't it?
I mean, that's it, isn't it? And I mean, listing gigs, it might sound like an easy job, but it takes hours and hours every week to collate all the gigs, you know. And so you haven't got the time to do that because you're doing the radio show. So I was already doing it, so it's just a perfect fit, isn't it? And if we can, you know, work together to help the bands and the venues out a little bit, then fingers crossed, it'll just put a few more bums on seats and everyone's the winner, aren't they? So
it's funny because it's all about. I mean, I do the radio show and people are probably just thinking, oh, I rock up on this Sunday evening and just crack on. But the amount of emails I have to send to achieve it, the amount of questionnaires I have to fill out, you know, for people that I'm interviewing, things like that, the whole descriptions on the band's backgrounds, the researching them and things like that, it goes on and on. The show,
it does.
The show is the easy bit for me.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, it's all the prep, isn't it? Prepping for your show takes so long, and then sitting and actually doing your show is the quick part.
That's the good bit,
you know.
Bit,
and like you said,